Yeah, one poached already.
This morning?
When we arrived, I believe.
There's been an elephant poached. Pretty devastating to have one poached already, but it's a big part of the problem.
I don't really know what happened. Sleeping bag last night, the poacher, the whole night with the nature sleeping bag like this. Nobody know about the poacher, where they go. Very difficult to catch and to find out the poachers.
He's
really love elephant and he want to see the poacher, who is the poacher, where is the poacher. But they are very worried about their life. They don't want to see and they don't want to make the enemy with the poacher. They take its skin. I think it's 500 square feet of the skin they take off from the elephant.
In the past, they poached for elephant just for ivory. But nowadays, not only ivory, also skin and trunk.
With the skin trade, they're removing females and babies and males. One of the quickest ways to drive a population to extinction is to take out breeding females and take out the young at the same time. It's really become a red alert situation. This is really a crucial time for us to be here and to use the tracking to try to clarify what is happening, where are the elephants moving, where they're being poached, and try to act upon that as quick as we can.
We're trying to put more collars. We know we will lose some, but this is the evidence of poaching. Otherwise, we don't know.
It's difficult to blame people when elephants are destroying their houses or their crops and someone comes along and offers them money to remove the elephants, but we hope that we can build trust in the communities and start to turn that tide against the poachers. We have a lot of really good links with Myanmar-based NGOs, with Burmese staff who go out into these communities, so we have this great relationship on the ground.
Because of this radio collar and all the messages, all the NGOs are working together and speak only one voice for the elephant, which is really good. Every minute we are losing our flora and fauna all over the world. But if we lose the elephant, we lose our national treasure. Our new generation will never get a chance to see a wild elephant.
To destroy something before you fully understand it is really a shame. We're not looking at elephants, we're looking at elephants within an active biodiverse landscape. It's about how the whole system functions. And if you start removing pieces, it's like pulling pieces from a tower. We don't know when it's all going to fall apart. We have no choice but to remain optimistic and to keep working.